Arise, 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 take your place, be enthroned on our praise. Ask of you one thing that we desire, that as we worship you, Lord, come and change our lives. Arise, 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 take your place, be enthroned on our praise. Arise, King of Kings, Holy God, as we sing.
Good morning, good morning. This is your wake up call. Pleasant good morning to each and everyone. As we welcome you inside, arise in the morning time, giving God thanks and praise that we are still in the land of the living. If we check out the news all over the world, many have gone to bed and is no longer here. Where are they? Well, according to the Bible, absent from the body, present with God for those who receive them. Absent from the body, present in torment for those who didn't. But we are here in the land of the living, so that is not our portion this morning. So we have been given the privilege and the honor to give Him thanks for saving us for yet another day in the land of the living. Father Almighty God, we thank you this morning that we are still in the land of the living. We are grateful. So for that, we give you praise, we give you worship, we give you honor, and we adore you this morning as King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Bless us today, Lord, that we are going to be productive and positive unto you. Amen. We thank you for this life. We won't take it for granted. In the name of your Son Jesus. So bless us.
Lord, come and inhabit
again
some of your people. How many of God's people do we have out there tonight? Sing this with me.
We lift you up. We lift you up.
We lift you up on our praises.
Yeah.
We lift you up. We lift you up. We lift you up on our praises.
Come on.
We lift you up. We lift you up. We lift you up on our praises.
Yeah.
We lift you up. We lift you up. We lift you up on our praises. We lift you up, we lift you up, we lift you up on our praises.
Yeah.
We lift you up, we lift you up, we lift you up on our praises. Arise, take your place, be enthroned on our praise. Arise, King of Kings, Holy God, as we sing.
Pinch yourself. You're here, yes, you're here, all right. You're here, you did. You made it, yes. Hallelujah. As we give thanks and praise to the Almighty God this morning, it is a pleasure to be here. I mean, I'm telling you, man, when you wake in the morning, sometimes it's like you really don't feel like you're all up to it. But once you step to it, you are empowered to continue to do all that you strive to do. So definitely we are thankful that we are able to even have that first spark in the morning time. I'm going to be reading Psalms 51 to get us started off today. Just stumbled upon it right here. Psalms 51. Have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercies. Blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from mine iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee, Against thee only have I sinned, and done this evil in thy sight, that thou mightest be justified when thou speakest, and be clear when thou judgest. Behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Behold, thou desirest truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part thou had make me to know wisdom. Purge me from hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me to hear joy and gladness, and the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice. Hide thy face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Then will I teach transgressors thy way, and sinners shall be converted unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing aloud of thy righteousness. O Lord, open thou my lips, and my mouth shall show forth thy praise, for thou desirest not sacrifice, else would I give it. Thou delightest not in burnt offering. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, thou wilt not despise. Do good in thy good pleasure unto Zion. Build thou the walls of Jerusalem. Then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifices of righteousness, with burnt offering and whole burnt offering. Then shall they offer bullocks upon thine altar in the name of Jesus. Indeed, arise in the morning. All those on the phone line, we acknowledge you. 213-493-0146. Thank you for waking up with us. All those on the website, www.choicegospelnetwork.com. Thank you for spreading the word. Amen. Thank you for the overflow as we lift up the name that has saved us, brought us back to life. Amen. Jesus, a name that is worthy to be praised, from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. If you're feeling weak in your soul this morning, we hope we can revive you. Something will be said from me or from someone that will keep you going. Amen. So listen with an open heart this morning. Inside the Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. Hey, Fox man, good morning. All the family out there, good morning to my beautiful one. Amen. As we give God thanks for you. If you're heading there for 8 o'clock, you should be on your way or almost ready to head out. If you're driving, be cautious. Kind of treacherous. Inside the tri-state area. Careful for black eyes if you're a driver. But in the meantime, drive to arrive alive. Amen. Cipriani, good morning.
Let the heavens rejoice. Let the earth be glad. Let the people of God sing his praise.
Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. Choice Radio.
Let the people of God sing his praise all over the land. Everyone in the valley, come and lift your voice. All those on the mountaintop, be glad, shout for joy. Let's worship the Holy One.
I don't care what the devil is telling you this morning.
Worship the Holy.
The great I Am.
Rise up and praise.
He is worthy to be praised every time.
Let's worship the Holy.
When we look back, where we coming from?
Rise up and praise Him.
My goodness, we must give Him time.
Let's worship.
We gotta be appreciative.
The One.
There's no way.
And praise Him. Let's worship the Holy One.
Don't allow yourself to forget.
And praise Him.
Where He took you from.
Let's worship.
From whence you came.
Holy One.
Look at you today.
And praise Him.
How many have faded away?
Let's worship the Holy.
10,000 have fallen your side, to the left and to the right. But here you go. Yes. Let us be a little appreciative this morning. Yeah, man.
Let's worship the Holy.
Rise up and give Him thanks.
Rise up and praise Him. Let's worship the Holy.
Sister Vel, good morning.
Rise up and praise Him.
Rise up and praise Him.
Let's worship the Holy.
This is the Pamela.
Rise up and praise Him. Let's worship the Holy.
All nurses, good morning.
All
doctors, good morning to you. All patients.
And praise Him.
Praise Him this morning.
He deserves our love. Let's rise up and praise Him.
Wow, I'm gonna do it again, indeed. Lowen Henry, my brother, my big brother, good morning. Yeah, all the folks in Radio Land, good morning to you. If you're driving, be cautious on the roads, all right? Drive to arrive alive. Get in there for 8 o'clock. You gotta do what only you can do right now. Get a move on. Amen.
On the mountain.
It. Good morning, all those already at the job. Good morning to you. Keep making your sacrifice, you know what I mean? Amen. Glory to the name that is above every name this evening, Father Almighty God. We thank you that you have brought us here another day again. We are grateful in the land of the living. Yes, indeed, we are happy to be here. Indeed. As we encourage each and everyone this morning to wake up with purpose this morning, you have been given another chance. Indeed, let's make good use of it in the name of Jesus. As we raise a sacrifice of praise to him, who is definitely worthy indeed, he gave us a free will. Indeed, your life, your salvation, your choice. Wake with different attitude this morning to improve what was weak, what didn't work. Wake up with a new attitude this morning. You've been given a new lease on life, a brand new sheet of paper, brand new book. Nothing written in there yet until you do. Brand new pen. Nice new ink. Hey. Hey, Collins family, morning. Sister Philippa. All the family in Radio Land, good morning to you. Sister Jay, good morning. Sister Gloria, Oakley family, Gabriel family, all the families, man. Hey.
How can I say thanks for everything you've done? And how can I give praise? Lord, you've given me so much. Sunshine and in rain, of praise. Oh, I lift it up to you. And Lord, I give my heart away. Oh, I give it all to you. Lord, make my life an offering. Let me worship you in everything I do. A sacrifice of praise I give to you. A sacrifice of praise, oh, I lift it up to you. Lord, I give my heart away. Oh, I give it all to you.
Amen, amen, amen. Glory to the name this morning. Don't care what you feel like, man. Gotta give him thanks. We are definitely appreciative that we are still in the land of the living, regardless to what. Amen. We are thankful. We are grateful this morning indeed. Give thanks for whatever it is, man. I don't know what is your situation, but we give thanks that we are here. You know what I mean? And we have the bread of life, and we definitely been given another chance to make it right. Whatever is wrong, we've been given another opportunity to make it right. So we definitely thank you this morning for listening. Many stations, we thank you for tuning to Choice Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice. And as long as God will have us to do this, to lift up his people and let them know that he has not forgotten them, he has not forsaken them. Indeed, we are definitely grateful and thankful that we have been used at this time to lift up the people of God and let them know that God is a good God and a great God, and he's worthy of all our praises indeed. If we look back and we check out history, I mean, everybody, oh, they can look back and say, man, hey, at least I'm here, you know what I mean? I'm here still, so hey, you know what I mean? I'm grateful. And this is the angle we have to look at it from time to time and say, well, regardless to what, but I'm here right now. And once you got life, you got hope. It's something that we always say from time to time. But if you really take it into perspective, it's really what it is. You know what I mean? Once we have life, we got hope. Something can turn around. Something can change and, you know, bring us to a place of comfort that even if we die the next second, we are comfortable, that we have that confidence that we will be going on to glory in the eternal reward. We'll be going up. You know what I mean? So once we have life, we got hope. And let's try to look in that zone, regardless to what it feels like, as we go into the presence of the Lord right about now in the name of Jesus.
God's glory on the wings, like the voice of many waters. I can hear the angels sing. Holy, singing holy, singing. The voice of many waters, I can hear the angels sing. This is the realm of your glory, this is the realm of your grace. All my heart's desire is to seek your face.
Worship him. I'm gonna touch it one more time as we worship him and we get into his presence this morning. Indeed, those just waking up from the bed, glory to the name of Jesus as we lift him up, knowing what he have done for us, where he have taken us from. Let us be appreciative this morning. Arise on Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. Miss S, amen. Never leave you, never forsake you. Almighty, bow down this morning.
Oh,
many waters, I can hear the angels sing. This is a realm of your glory, this is a realm of your grace. All my heart's desire is to seek your face.
Praise this morning. Acknowledge him this morning. Whatever is over your eyes that you cannot see the love of him, allow God to move it. Remove the veil from your eyes so you can get a closer look at what has been given unto you. Hallelujah. Glory to the name above every name, Jesus. All those in the nursing homes, good morning to you. And this, you know, this morning we're gonna really take a look. I was deciding to just open the phones this morning and allow you to air your concerns, something, whatever that may be on your spirit. But I'm definitely moved this morning to open this conversation about those who are mad with God. People who are mad with God and feel that God has not dealt them a fair hand, and for that they resent coming to him. We're gonna look into that, see what the scripture have to say about that. Amen. And see if it's any fault of God for your predicament or for one's predicament according to the Holy Scriptures. Amen. And the same 24 hours in a day for you and I. We're going to look into it. 741 Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. As we lift him up this morning, are you grateful this morning? Don't care what it feels like. You are here in the land of the living. May the millionaire could abide that day from you. Amen. Some millionaire who have died could have bought that day from you right now. Mm-hmm. Do you want to sell it? Is it for sale? Hey, Miss Gunpot, good morning. Hey, Mount Sinai.
And as we sing holy, and as we sing worthy,
Miss Alana,
cherubim angels,
and Jack Crew,
and they're ushering in the throne.
Sister Angie, morning.
Every time we sing worthy, and every time we sing holy, we're like
Pastor the, Paul, good morning to you.
Surround the throne.
All those in the body of Christ.
And the angels are bringing the throne of God into the room.
In the nursing field, as we encourage you to give it your best. Give every man your best. Equal love. Amen.
All we want is Jesus.
Pastor family, good morning to you.
Make room for the King.
Hey, Calisi.
Room for the King.
Good morning.
Let the King of Kings.
Hey, Tanti Pat, good morning.
And the King of Glory come.
Sister Carol, good morning to you.
The host.
Sister Kador.
Strong and mighty.
And all the family, man. As we lift up the name of Jesus. Sister Linda, morning to you. Sister Colleen. Brother Lawrence. Experience his power and experience his Shekinah glory. I know when you hear this kind of song, you just imagine yourself on the other side, you know.
Nation of the King.
Yeah.
The King of Glory.
It's gonna be something though.
Mm-hmm. I wanna see the King.
It's gonna be something. I don't wanna miss it.
Stop. You join in with the angels. Sing with the angels. And they're singing holy. They're singing holy. They're singing holy. We've got the angels and the 20 more elders and the cherubim and the seraphim and the glory of God.
Serena, morning to you. Amen. And all the fans out there in Radio Land, we thank you, man. And most of all those who write us, man, those who, you know, really love what we're doing and sincere and have written to us, we definitely acknowledge you, all right? Those who have not received the card from us yet, we are going to get to you. Amen. But we acknowledge you, those who sincerely really appreciate what Choice Radio is trying to accomplish. We definitely thank you, all right?
Oh,
yes, indeed.
Holy, holy.
Give him praise this morning.
Holy.
And this morning we'll be talking about, I've experienced a couple, holy. I've met a couple people and mentioned Jesus and mentioned certain things.
Holy.
I'm talking about,
holy.
Probably people that are sick or whatever it is.
Holy.
And they feel God has abandon them. Don't know if you ever met anybody like that. Many people are mad with God after they have lived the life carelessly. I don't know if you ever experienced anything like that. Is God at fault? Hallelujah. That bright morning. Hey, Miss Morrison, good morning.
Feels like heaven. I feel like I'm in heaven. Heaven. This is what we're singing in heaven.
Hey, Brother Edwin, good morning to you, man.
It's like heaven. So close to heaven. Right before the throne. Trembling.
Sister Esther, good morning. Sister Suzette.
We don't
Sister Gloria, Virginia.
Because the King is worthy.
Wilbert Michelle, morning.
All we want is His fire.
All the family on the phone line.
That is holy fire.
Lifting up the name this morning, baby.
We want His fire.
He's worthy to be praised.
We want His glory. We want the smoke of His glory. Holy, holy glory.
Hey, Mr. Antoine, good morning. If you're born again and you know it, have you put on your old suit already? Your complete suit? Have you put on your whole suit? Amen. Sister Nicole, good morning.
Today's my day.
I know some people have that suit in the closet for a while. They only put on one piece. They have not put on the whole suit yet. Those who have put on the whole suit.
Today's my
changing to your whole creature. Your whole new creature. Head everything change. Ears change. Foot change. Hands change. New creature.
Today's my day. You changed my name. I might limp away, but I'll never be the same. Oh, 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 oh. I'll never be the same. Never be the same. Oh, 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 I'll never be the same. Never be the same. Today's my day. You changed my away,
never be the same. Oh, 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 I'll never be the same. I'll never be the same. Oh, 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 I'll never be the same.
Guess what? I'll never be the same.
But I'll never be the same. Oh, today's my day. Today's my
Jennifer Morning on the way to work. Wow, almost 8 o'clock. Man, I'll tell you something is going on with the time. Once it's 7, it's 8. Once it's 8, it's 9. Once it's 10, it's 11. And so on and so forth. Choice Radio. As we just thank God for this opportunity this morning, hope we can be a blessing to you. Somehow we can impact your life to keep going on with Jesus, man. Because it's the realest thing that ever happened in my life, you know what I mean? I don't care what it feels like, I already know what I know.
Never be the same.
Gotta pay me a lot to really get me out.
Never be the same.
I don't think there's enough money in the world to pay me and buy me out. If I'm turning back, going back, no.
Cause today's my day.
Is today your day?
change my name.
Many people are mad with God after living their lives carelessly. Amen. Is that something that we can talk about this morning? To remind somebody that
right now,
once you got life, you got hope, and God is stretching his hands out.
Let's be still in it.
Is there any testimony we can bring forth this morning to encourage some soul that has
forget who's
given up on God and all his plan and promise?
Holy.
Can we together as a family this morning
right now, while his
open this up?
Let's be still in it. Just gaze at his presence. Forget who's around you. Forget who.
Sister Vanessa, good morning.
Just that
Brother Nelson.
Presence.
Brother David, morning.
Jesus.
See ya. Congratulations.
I'll be still in your presence. I'll be stranded forever. It's your name that I lift, Lord. Oh God. I'll be still in your presence. I'll be stranded forever. It's your name that I lift, Lord. Oh God, your name is.
This is the Martha morning.
Holy Lord, your name is holy God. Your name is holy Lord. Your name is holy God.
Somebody sing, I'll be still in your presence. And I'll be stranded forever, Jesus. It's your name that will lift higher.
Oh God,
I'll be still in your presence. I'll be stranded forever. It's your name that I'll live, Lord. Oh God, your name, your name is holy, Lord. Somebody tell him, your
Sister Maria, morning.
Your name is
Sister Alice.
Holy God.
Somebody come on, help us. I'll be still in your presence.
I'll be stranded
forever. It's your name that I'll live, Lord. Oh God. I'll be still in your presence. I'll be stranded forever. It's your name.
Sister Esther, how you doing? Glory to the name that is above every name. As we definitely approach the 8 o'clock in the morning time, you know, it was really on my mind just to open the phone lines, because we know that from different time to time Every man have a different something that is on their chest, on their stomach.
Just cry,
and them that they want to share, or they want to...
Holy are you, Lord.
You know what I mean?
You are holy.
But it just struck me this morning about this right here.
You are holy.
And like I say, whatever we bring on the conversation is just to awaken us, you know what I mean?
That's,
there is hope. Once there is life, there is hope. You know, things can turn around. Things can change, you know what I mean? We cannot just take it for what it is and feel there is no solution. But that's the end, you know what I mean? Many people are mad with God after they have lived their life carelessly. Hey, my sister from Jamaica, this one is for you. Forget you, didn't get your name right.
You don't have to worry, and don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning, troubles, they don't last away. Cause there's a friend in Jesus who will wipe your tears.
As we open the phone lines.
And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say.
And if you're going to call, please call concerning the topic this morning.
Yeah, I know that I can't.
Anything that is extracurricular, that has nothing to be on the air, no reason to be on the air, please let us do it off the air at another time.
With him I know
it means use your brain.
No matter what may.
Amen. There are some things that does not be need to be on the air, especially if you're listening to me and you hear what we're talking about. It is totally inappropriate to call with something totally abstract from the conversation. Amen. But we thank you. Nevertheless, don't take it personal, all right?
I give you all the glory.
Just want to keep the program flowing.
You don't have to worry, and don't you be afraid. Joy comes in.
347-663-8638. And if you got a testimony to share with us, we definitely would appreciate a testimony this morning. If you want us to pray with you on something, feel free.
Just lift your hands and say, I know that I can make it. I know that I.
If you can call and share with us, we definitely appreciate your story. If you have encountered anyone like that, people who are mad at God and don't want to hear about God because they feel that God has dealt them a bad hand.
Although your tests and trials, they seem to get you down. All your friends and loved ones.
If you know somebody like this or you have encountered a situation like that,
remember there's a friend in Jesus.
Yeah, we definitely appreciate your call this morning, all right? Even if it was you one time in life, you know what I mean? Before you came to the light.
I know that I can make it. I know.
Because we might be able to awaken someone this morning.
Oh,
and let them know that God is on their side.
My life is in his hands.
Amen.
With Jesus I can.
Miss Kerr, good morning.
I know that I can stand. No matter what may come.
Good morning to all missionaries.
My life is.
All pastors, ministers of the gospel. Good morning to you.
You don't have to worry.
347-663-8638. The phone is now open. If you have a story or what we stated this morning, if there is any depths to it, if it can take any traction this morning and be of some light, some effect to somebody who have given up on God because thought that God has not come true fast enough.
No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. With Jesus, I
if It's a good conversation. Let me know if you think it's, you know.
No, I'll stand. No matter what may come my way.
347-663-8638. Good morning. Arise in the morning.
All your friends and loved ones, they ain't nowhere to be found. Remember, remember, there's a friend in Jesus who will wipe your tears away.
Yeah. Brother Brian, good morning to you, man. Hey, Brother Carla.
I know that I can.
Brother Carla, good morning to you, man.
I know that I can.
All the family, Deacon.
No,
all the deacons, deaconess. Many people are mad because of God. They think that God is the source or the reason why they have fallen in diverse temptation, caught in some trap or some snare. Indeed, amen. If it's a fair question, let me know if it's a fair question. If you think there are people who don't receive Christ because of that.
I can make it. I know that I can stay.
Hey, Brother Raymond, morning to you, man. People that are mad with God, they don't want to hear nothing about God.
With him, I know.
Because they feel God has not done them right.
My love is in his name. Although your chest and
track. 347-663-8638.
All your friends and loved ones, I know where to live.
Remember, there's a friend in Jesus.
As we go to the first caller this morning, we appreciate the calls, you know that, right? Caller, good morning.
Praise God, good morning. How are you, Dublo?
I'm great, my sister. How are you doing?
I'm blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Yeah, I have a cousin, and he don't believe in God. He hates God because his grandmother, I don't know his grandmother, he's my cousin by my mom's father, brother's side, but I don't know his grandmother. And I was talking to him, witnessing to him, and you don't want nobody to tell me about no God because his grandmother was a Christian, and she was sick, and she passed away. And he said, if God was real, his grandmother would still be alive because she was doing his work, and she prayed all the time, and she'd go to church and all sorts of things. And when she was sick, he was saying, God, if you real, save my grandmother, save my grandmother. And his grandmother passed away, so nobody cannot tell him nothing about God, because God is not real.
Was he saved at that time?
He is still not saved.
No, was he saved when he requested for God to save his mother, his grandmother?
He's not saved. He wasn't saved, never been saved before.
Well, I mean, according to the Bible, God listens not to sinners, you know what I mean? So a sinner really cannot go into the face of God, and with that kind of attitude, making
exactly
a request, I don't think God is no respecter of persons. So if you probably reference God, he might get a different result rather than just telling God, prove yourself to me, you know what I mean, in that kind of fashion.
Right. But at the same time, his grandmother, as you said, was working for the Lord, and he take you whenever he feel like it. She probably have done what he wanted her to do, and it's time for her to go to him.
Well, amen. That's the thing about it is, you know, God have his way, and you know, everybody, you
his
know,
way is not our way.
Exactly.
He needs to get over it and get himself saved, but he's very ignorant, and you cannot say nothing to him. He bring up some, he's saying that there's scientific proof that there's no God. I said, show me proof that there's no God. He said, well, this say this, and I said, my God is real, because he worked for me. You work for me, so nobody can tell me they did anything scientific to show otherwise. Nothing.
So you're saying they use some kind of God scanner and scan the world?
Yes, man.
A God scanner, and they pick up nothing, right?
Yes.
Everything came back, boop, 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 boop. No God, yeah. Boop, 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 no God there. Boop, boop, boop.
God is real. You need to give him a chance. So we need to pray for that boy too.
So let me ask you something. Are you saying this is a topic or a conversation that is worthy to be had?
Yes, because for this person, maybe I could do more, tell him more, you know? And maybe I need that information.
Amen.
But, I mean, a lot of people who is not even saved listen to the program, so they need to hear it too.
Amen. Thank you, my sister.
You're welcome. Be blessed.
Yeah, man.
Yes, Jesus.
I pray. 30 minutes past the 8 o'clock. Thank you for my first caller with your first deposit. Many people are mad with God.
You don't have to worry.
Because they feel God has not come true for them.
Be afraid. Joy comes in the morning.
Do you know somebody like that? Three four seven six six three eight six three eight.
And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, I know that I can make it. I know that I.
If you are mad at God this morning, give me a call too.
What may come my way? My life is in it.
347-663-8638.
I can take it. With him, I know.
He's worthy to be praised.
No matter.
But if you think otherwise, give us a call this morning. 347-663-8638.
To get you down. All your friends and loved ones are nowhere to be found. Remember, there's a friend in Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say,
hey, caller, good morning. We thank you.
Praise the Lord. Good morning. God
praise
bless you.
God bless you too, my
I
sister.
Have a testimony on behalf of a young man. He's out of state, and I gave him your number because he needs to let others know who God is to him. What happened was, like 25 years ago, he left New York City and went, had a wife, and went with a German girlfriend. She took him away to Washington State. And he lived there with her for a little while, and but he was a party guy, the park creator, playing the steel pan, things like that. And so she wanted to get him away from his family, and he did go. And there was an accident, a simple accident, because he was a drinker and all that, and he broke his neck. When he broke his neck, in those days, 1989, it was very difficult. It's not like, no, there's a chance. But at that time, there would have been no chance, according to the specialist. And when the specialist called and said that he's going to, by the time his people get to Washington, he'll be dead. And when he said that, for me, it's my brother. For me, I wasn't ready for that. And so I said to him, are you are you going to be the surgeon? Because he said, there's got to be some surgery because he's totally paralyzed from his neck down. And he said, yes. He said, his name is Dr. McKay. I said, well, Dr. McKay, because it was a shock to me. But I'm a woman of the cloth. I know God. I know who he is. And I said, Dr. McKay, you are one physician, and I know of a great physician, and that's Jesus Christ. And I'm not ready to let my 27-year-old brother go. And so he said, Miss, with that kind of fate, you need to come on and let's get this done. Well, glory to God. It was a long process, and he's still paralyzed. Got some money, a few thousand dollars from the accident, you know, and didn't marry to this woman because he was already married, two kids, and they're in Washington State. She started to treat him very badly. The money was dwindling. There was a house and everything. And the aide that was taking care of him really got attached to him because he was like Mr. Cool, Mr. Wonderful. And something went on there between them. Long story short, he's on the third floor, cannot move, can't dust a fly from his nose, but just there, spirit lifted, just happy. He was a man into his horses. Get him to the stable, and he was fine. The next thing we know that she was on drugs, had friends with drugs, weed and all of that. Now he's close with the girlfriend, this girl that is taking care of him now, because of course you're going to lean towards where you're being helped. Because she used to leave him for hours and not clean him up and things like that. So what happened was he got closer to this girl. Well, he told her he was going to go with the girl, keep the house. He's going to go with the girl because she's taking care of him. Well, about 3 days after he said that and she realized that he was making that kind of arrangement, she put drugs under his pillow, under his bed. They were drugs. And the police came, helped him up. Man cannot feed himself. Let me tell you about Spokane, Washington. They found him guilty of being a drug dealer, being a quadriplegic that can't even feed himself. Put him away in a federal prison for 10 long years. But out of that evil came good. And what happened was they learned him how to help himself and to do different things. Ordinarily, he would not have been able to do that. Today, he's in a wheelchair. He's driving that. He's doing that wheelchair as though it's a Ferrari because he calls it his Ferrari. And he said at the time of that 10 years that they put him away in that federal hospital, that prison, he was able to minister to people in there. He watched them die. He didn't allow them to die alone because he could have moved around. And he was just ministering in that 10 years. We wanted him back in New York. They sent him back to Spokane, Washington. He's there with two of his children. But guess what's going on now? They want to deport him because, of course, he was in a federal prison. And that's the law. Well, it's going to be a fight. We're not worried about that. But what I want to talk about this morning is that a man that is not angry with God or angry with nobody, that woman went back to Germany. He's talking with her, and he's telling everybody about the love of God. And whatever God says, that is what God will do. He said he's a good God. He's a great God. And this is all this young man is holding on to. The doctors say he couldn't live for 5 years. I want to tell you that it has been 25 years. So when man say no, God says yes. And if you see him driving around and if you see him, see his picture, you couldn't tell that this man still is paralyzed. So I want to say that God is a good God. And we go through things. And family members were angry with this woman. And, you know, all kinds of things went through people's heads. But today, glory be to God. So I want to say that God is good. And regardless of whatever you're going through, joy comes in the morning if you hold on to him and if you know him. So God bless you.
Amen, my sister. Thank you for that illustrious testimony this morning. I appreciate it in Jesus' name. Amen?
Yes.
Thank you, my sister. Wow, what a testimony. What a testimony this morning. 22 minutes on the other side of 8.
Yes, Jesus. I praise you, Lord. I give you all the glory.
Wow. If you know someone that is mad at God,
joy comes in the morning.
Let us hear your story this morning. As we encourage those on the outside,
there's a friend in Jesus.
There is no reason to be angry with him. 347-663-8638. If you know someone who is angry with God, don't want to hear it. Even if it was you at one time in your life.
With Jesus I'm taking, with him I know I stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in his hand. Although your tests and trials, they seem to get you down. All your friends and loved ones, I'm nowhere to be found. Remember there's a friend in Jesus.
Hey, my name is Edwards.
Just lift your hands and say,
Brother Andrew Edwards, morning.
And make it, I know that I can stand.
347-663-8638. If you have a testimony this morning, or you know somebody who is mad with God, as we give out this first scripture for the day, James 1:13. You can say from James 1:12. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation, for when he's tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord had promised to them that love him. Let no man say when he is tempted, I am tempted of God. For God cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempted he any man. But every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. Then when lust had conceived, it bringeth forth sin. And sin, when it is finished, bringeth forth death. 347-663-8638. Like I said, this morning we just want to awaken. And that's basically the objective right here. To awaken some of the things that people,
yes, Jesus,
don't really pay attention to.
I give you all the glory.
And could be the biggest hindrance in our walk with Christ and in encouraging others to come on to him.
And don't you be afraid.
This morning we're talking about people who just
morning,
have it in for God because they feel that God has not dealt them fairly. And mainly we're trying to talk about those who, I mean, people who have lived a careless life all the way through. And now they look back at their life and blaming God. And
no matter what may come my way, my life is in his hand. With Jesus I can take.
347-663-8638. Don't be shy if it's you.
Remember,
if you're out there in Radio Land and
Jesus,
some things you don't understand yet, or some things you're still having questions,
just lift your hands and
we can talk about it.
I know that I can make it. I know that
maybe you can get some advice from the audience. Somebody who's out there and properly equipped. 347-663-8638.
No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands.
Let us make a joyful noise, and to the Lord.
347-663-8638. If you're getting there for 9, you should almost be right there right now. Arise in the morning time on Choice Radio.
Oh, what a
your life, your salvation, your choice. Jesus should be your choice.
Glory divine.
As you go back to the phone lines, caller, good morning to you.
Bless the Lord. Good morning, my brother in Christ.
Amen. Bless the Lord. Amen.
I greet you in the matchless name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
This testimony I have for you is not yours. It's not mine, sorry, but I heard it on the radio one day, on the Christian radio station one day, and it truly blessed me. And I hope it's a word of encouragement for my brethren out there in Radio Land. One white lady gave her testimony. She's an evangelist for Christ now. She said she was raised as an atheist, absolutely not to believe in God, no God exists, and even if a God did exist, why did he allow such things to happen to people on the earth? And she said she was raised like that. She had no issue with it because she didn't know anything differently. She had nothing to compare it to. She grew up, got married, and had a child of her own, and she adored her daughter. She She spoiled her daughter. Everything was for that little girl. And one day her daughter got so sick. I don't remember what disease she had. She ended up in a hospital and was on respirator and tubes coming out from everywhere. And the doctors told her, you know, they're going to try their best, but they don't think she's going to make it. One of the doctors told her, listen, we think you should go home and clean up because, you know, you've been in the hospital for so many days. Go home and refresh yourself and come back. She said when she got into the car and she closed the door, she started screaming at God, telling him how much she hated him. She started blaspheming his name and cussing. And she said she was so hysterical that she started crying, that she threw herself on the steering wheel, sobbing hysterically. And she said out of the clear blue she heard, well, at least you're talking to me. She said she jumped up and she looked around. She's alone in the van. And God introduced himself to her that day. And she repented of all she's ever done against God. She talked with God. She got to know him right there in the car. And she left and she did go home. And while she was home fixing herself up, she got a call from the hospital telling her that there's a change in her daughter and she needs to come quick. By the time she got back to the hospital, her daughter was already sitting up in bed, fine, no trace of any disease, no sickness, asking, where is my mommy? And Hallelujah. She realized there is a true and living God.
Hallelujah. Wow.
She went from not believing in God to being mad at God. Now she serves God with her whole heart.
Wow, what a testimony. But you see, what is crucial about this testimony here is that she really didn't know, you know, she was ignorant of it. And the bad thing about it is, you know, as what we always encourage people, God wants you to know for yourself. As an adult, there is no way you can just listen to people and take what they say and live it like that. God wants us as consulting adults to seek him. Find out for yourself. Come to me. Come to me humbly based on who I am, the King of Kings, Lord of Lords. Come to me humbly with reverence and ask me, Amen. Seek me, and then you could make a decision after that. But once you come to God willfully and willingly, God is willing to explain, to teach you, to tell you whatever it is you want to know if your heart and your motive is right.
Amen.
Wow. Thank you for that. Go ahead.
I just want to thank you for being so patient. You always encourage us, you know, to call in and give our 2 cents. You know, I know a lot of people out there are nervous, just like I am. Sometimes when I'm dialing the number, my hands are shaking so much.
For real?
I don't know why. Yes. I thank God, you know, because now as I'm talking to you, you know, the Holy Spirit is saying it's reverential fear of the Lord. You have to be careful what you say to God's people.
Amen, amen, amen. Well,
I thank God.
Sorry, one thing I've found out is that once your intention is right, the Holy Spirit will empower you to keep imparting words. And that's why you say you're going to bring back everything to your knowledge. Once you are in Christ and your spirit and your motive is uplifting, Christ will continue to put the right things into you. That's what I've noticed over the time. Is it your motive is what is crucial with God. If your intention is right, God will continue to feed into your spirit. Our pastor was saying that there are times he looked back at recordings he did and service and stuff, and he never remember when he did it, what he said in it. But you see, if you come in with the right motive, God will always feed you and give you and let you do what is right. Because your motive is right. That's what drives God, is your motive.
Amen, amen.
Amen?
And I beg you one favor because you're always so patient with me. That same group, Shekinah Glory, they have a song called Jesus. And I beg you play that for my brethren out there. It is a really encouraging song.
Amen. I think I saw that one too yesterday when you sent me for the other one.
Okay.
So indeed, thank you for this information. Amen.
Yes, you're welcome.
Be blessed. All right.
Stay blessed.
You too.
Let us make
33 minutes on the other side of 8 o'clock. What a testimony, man.
And, to the Lord.
And if you're out there listening to radio and you don't know God and you, for some reason you feel that you hear about God and based on how your life has turned out and how things have happened in your life and stuff like that, man, if you're an adult, God wants to know you for himself. And that's why I say this already. I encourage everybody. I don't care what religion, what denomination, God wants you to find out what it is you don't know, what you don't understand. Come to him and he's going to tell you. That is the kind of God he is. Don't follow denomination. Don't follow religion. Don't take what they're telling you and just go along because they show you a couple of scriptures and justify what scripture they read to why they say what they say. But go to God, say, God, I don't understand this. Some people don't believe or whatever. I don't want to say I don't believe it, but I want you to show me. God liked that approach. And this is the right approach for everything that has to do with the Bible. If somebody else is saying it, you don't get it, you don't feel that is right, don't condemn it. If it's written in the book, do not condemn it. Go ahead and ask God to reveal it. Say, God, I don't understand. And if your motive is right and your intention is right, as a person who loves the Lord and loves his word and just want to be as upful as you can with his word, he will put the right thing in your spirit. He will let you know, yes, you're right, my sister. No, you're wrong. He will show you. He will find a way and meet you on your level and let you understand his ways and what he wants you to believe in and what he wants you to do. That's why I encourage every single person, do not allow the sun to go down on your life by just believing what people tell you and going with that comfort and feeling, well, that's what it is. God wants you to find out from him yourself, to make sure you have dotted all the I's and crossed all the T's before you leave this place, because he's a faithful and just God, and his intention is for you to know him as an individual. You didn't come here with nobody. Don't care how credible they seem to you, nothing wrong with that. You could appreciate people, you could whatever, but at the end of the day, it's all about you and God. I heard a young lady talk about something last night that a pastor, whatever, say that if you have to go to any church to visit, you have to come to them first. And even if you go, you have to consider that as your resignation letter and all this kind of stuff. There is liberty in Christ. You know, if you're born again Christian, there is a freedom that goes along with it. And everybody should be able to exercise that freedom. So anybody who kind of put this kind of thing to you, that's a red flag right there immediately. You know, it's a no-no, period. As a big person, that man, look, I'm a big man. I'm a big woman. That's it. You ain't telling me. I'm not your child. You can tell me I can't go here and I can't go there. I don't care what your problem is with these people or that people. I'm not involved in that. I am me. That's it. I think that's what God wants us to say and be strong enough to say. This is my life. It's my life. It's my salvation. And it's my choice. And I will make the choice that is appropriate to me and my God. Just a little sideshow here, you know what I mean? But that's important, though, for people to understand that. Anybody give you that kind of attitude,
let us make,
you need to be very wary. Amen?
And to the Lord.
36 minutes past the 8 o'clock. 347-663-8638. You're a child of God, not a child of man.
Jesus is mine.
And this morning we zero in on people who, you know, don't believe in God because they feel that God has done them something wrong or God has not come true for them.
Divine.
Amen. If you're out there in Radio Land and for some reason you're not persuaded to serve him, to accept what has happened in your life, give us a call. Let us hear your situation. Let's hear your story.
Washed in his blood.
Who knows? Maybe you have a point. 347-663-8638.
Story. This is my song.
What is your story this morning? Choice Radio.
Praising.
All those on the phone lines, we love you in the name of Jesus. Thank you for listening. Thank you for telling a friend.
All the day long.
Give somebody life today. Give them Choice Radio.
This is my story.
What is your story?
This is my song.
Have you ever encountered someone who is mad at God?
Praising my Savior. All the day long.
Hey, the Green family, good morning. Pastor Green.
Perfect submission.
Please turn off your radio caller. perfect. I'm going to disengage you immediately indeed. As we continue to remind you, please, and if you call the phone is telling you, please turn off your radio before we take you live. That means you should be obedient, all right? So please try to be obedient. Let's present a great show to the world.
Make a joyful noise.
That we are capable and of being professional. Can we do that? Amen?
Blessed. A show.
347-663-8638. Turn off your radio if you're calling us.
Jesus,
we're gonna have a phone conversation.
Oh,
if you wanna hear back yourself, you can go on the website and look for when we upload the show.
Glory divine.
Into our directory, alright? ChoiceGospelNetwork.com.
347-663-8638. Purchase of God. Born of His Spirit.
We want to encourage some soul this morning. Do not die without knowing Jesus. He loves you so much.
In His blood.
Give Him a fair chance this morning.
This is my story.
Hey, caller, good morning to you.
Good morning, Pastor.
Amen.
How are you?
I'm doing great in the name of Jesus, my sister. I'm blessed.
Thank you so much.
Amen.
For taking my call.
You're welcome.
But I'm asking, I said thank you for taking my call.
Amen.
And I'm asking you if you can speak to me off the air.
All right, let's do that. Hold the phone, all right?
Yes.
Amen.
Let us make a joyful noise. And to the Lord. Blessed assurance. Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Year of salvation, purchased of God. Born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture all burst from my sight. Angels descend, bringing from above echoes of mercy, whisper of love. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior.
Amen.
All the day.
praise him all the day long. And this is what we want to encourage you, to praise him all the day long because of our experience with God. And I mean, yeah, we are excited to lift up the name of Jesus before our people, people who can relate to us and people who understand the sound of our voice and people who understand us and our culture and everything else, even that too, you know. But we definitely, you know, there is no limiting to God, and, you know, God is not about limitation. And to everybody out there, we are excited to tell you that Jesus is real, and you know what I mean? And one key element about what, you know, I found about Jesus is that, you know, you have to come to him with reverence. You know, I think it's important that Christian people really get that in their mind, that you cannot just come to God anyhow. You know, God is God, you know what I mean? You know, if you got to go to the president, even to your prime minister, you probably dress up in your best clothes and you carry on and you tell everybody, and you know what I mean? You're just probably the mayor, you know what I mean? And when you go to God, you come like anyhow. And, you know, come on, we must reverence where reverence is due. And if he's the King of Kings, we must approach him that way. Caller, good morning.
Good morning, my brother. How are you?
I'm great. How are you doing?
Can I talk to you for a few minutes off the air?
All right.
Let us make a joyful noise. And to the Lord. Blessed assurance. Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine.
And we are definitely happy and pleased to say happy birthday to our big friend at Choice Radio, Brother Brian. And he got saved on Choice Radio. He got saved, well, through Choice Radio. He came to Christ. And, I mean, he's living his best life right about now. So, happy birthday to you, Brother Brian. Let me see if I find your selection here for you. And it's coming from your wife-to-be. She wants to send out a request to you. Amen. Sister Anne, good morning.
This is my song.
And like I was saying before, I was talking about reverence for God. We must come to a place to understand that if we say he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, no, there must be some kind of request and some kind of decorum when we approach his presence, when we come to him. There must be some sort of fear that would emanate from us if we really see God as God. And I can understand why some people will, you know, they might be saying they're seeking God and, you know, God is not this and God is not that. Because you have to, you know, kind of, you know, stop and really check. Are you coming to God as God? I mean, God, the creator of heaven and earth? Or are you coming to God like your child, like your son, like your children, like people you play outside with? Are you coming to God in that kind of way? How are you coming to God? How are you reverencing God? You know what I mean? That's very crucial and very important. And I think that we should pay attention to that. Anybody out there listening to the radio right now, you have not received Christ as your Lord and Savior, or you have not seen him in that light, you don't see the need for all that, and because you have not experienced God, or probably you have experienced him but not pay any attention to it. But what is very important and crucial is that you must see God as God. You must see him in that capacity to really be able to access him. You know, and your heart have to be sincere. It is important that a man's heart is sincere. Like we mentioned this a couple of times before, that a person might say, yes, they accept Christ with their mouth and just go there and everybody say, well, come and receive Christ. But if you have not accepted Christ in your heart, it is not really easy to make a distinction that if you have been touched or not, if there is a transformation, if something have happened, something have left you, something new has begun in you. And I think this is one of the applications I think that is needed. And that's why I know that, you know, God is a God that wants to make sure that his people don't perish for a lack of information. That's why I think, you know, at this time, you know, we talk a certain way. And somebody might say the same thing, but say it so casual and so, you know, put probably so much flair into it that you miss the really, you miss the gist of it. You miss the real emphasis on what is important in that application. Yes, you might receive Christ, but you have to receive Christ in your heart. You have to fall in love with Jesus. You have to just open up the inside of you and let him in it that way. And now that you know you love him and you accept him in that way, you have to leave the altar, leave that place wherever you receive him. knowing that you have just received him, you fell in love with him from that day, and you start thinking on that level that you're now in love with Jesus. And then Jesus is able to grow on you, and you are able to bear fruits and see yourself coming in and coming in and coming in. And that way you will make that connection and have that communication. Because we now need to make some sort of emphasis in ourselves to see that we have received something on the inside. You understand me? For it to start to manifest on the outside, we have to acknowledge that we have received that person. It's like you just find somebody else, and then you start acting different with your previous girlfriend. And she say, why are you acting so strange? You didn't call me today. What happened? Because there is somebody else in the picture. It's the same way as falling in love with Jesus. There is somebody else in the picture that's taking away your attention from other things. So when you receive Christ, it's the same kind of enthusiasm, same kind of emphasis that has to be exhibiting from you if you receive Christ. And that is what's going to grow and develop, because you start nurturing that love. You start calling up that person, you know, because they just give you the information. excuse me. And you said you like them. So now you start developing that relationship with you and that person. And it's going to grow and grow and grow. And the more the person is responding to you, and the more you are reaching out to them, you are able to get evidence that this person is also interested in you. So that's something that, yeah, I think it needs to be stated from time to time, so people can understand the application of being a Christian and being a believer in Christ. One caller mentioned yesterday about, oh, well, the devil is using this and the devil is using that. You need to put more emphasis on who God is and who Jesus is than who the devil is. Because we are the one who give the devil power to operate in our life. And the same way we give God the power to operate in our life. So whichever one you put the more focus on, it will determine which one will take preeminence, which one you give the better seat in your life. You know what I mean? So a believer need to pay attention to those little things that seem to be trivial or, you know, just, you know, little side talk, because it's actually the real meat of the matter. If you don't know how to apply something to your life, you're really not going to see the full manifestation of it, because it's not been properly applied. You understand me? So it's important for somebody out there in radio land to believe what you believe and let that belief sink inside. Not just on the topical area. Let that belief sink inside your heart, that your heart have received it inside, internally. It's an internal transformation that will then show on the outside of what you're doing on the inside. That's why the Bible talk about, you know, whatever come from the heart will definitely come out of the mouth sooner or later. You know what I mean? So it's important that we mention these little things there that, you know, somebody will understand. So like I said, the phone is open still. It's 8:51. It's definitely Arise in the Morning time on Choice Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice. As we're getting ready to celebrate with our brother who is celebrating his birthday, Brother Brian, right about now.
It's 007. It's 007. To be lifted and refreshed, you gotta turn your radio.
Choice Radio, Choice Radio.
This music brings healing, brings joy and life to the depressed. Oh, gotta keep on.
Happy be a birthday to you. Happy be a birthday to you. Happy be a birthday. Happy be a birthday. Happy be a birthday to you.
I am a winner, winner, and winners never quit. More than a conqueror, mighty conqueror. Destined for success. Oh, I'm a winner, and that's it. that's it. I am a winner, winner, and winners never quit. More than a conqueror, mighty conqueror, destined for success. Oh, I'm a winner, and that's it. In spite of the many times I've fallen, I'm gonna pick myself up. Knowing my destiny's mine to fulfill. These trials won't define me. These struggles won't ever win. I'm determined my purpose to fulfill. I am a winner, a winner, and winners never quit. More than a conqueror, mighty conqueror, destined for success. Oh, I'm a winner, and that's it. Yeah. Oh, I'm a winner, and that's it. I know we are living in troubled times, but I won't give in. I'll keep on living and dreaming big dreams.
I want the song to soak in, Brother Brian.
God is for me, and by His strength I win. I'm determined my purpose to fulfill. 'Cause I am a winner, a winner, and winners never quit. More than a conqueror, mighty conqueror, destined for success. Oh, I'm a winner, and that's it. I am a winner, a winner, and winners never quit. More than a conqueror, mighty conqueror, destined for success. Oh, I'm a winner, and that's it.
Tell you, man, you're a winner, my brother.
I'm a winner.
Knowing where he took you from.
That's it. Ooh. Winner.
Know that you're a winner this morning in Jesus. And you know, we believe that God is a spirit, man. We have to believe in the spirit that He have brought us through, you know what I mean? And that's something that we're missing out a lot. You gotta believe in the spirit that He has brought us through mighty, mighty things. Amen. Happy birthday to you, Brother Brian. From the entire Choice family, man. We thank God for many, many that have received Christ through this medium of being awakened spiritually by Choice Radio. We give Him all the praise and all the honor and all the glory, because all is due unto Him. Amen. Thank you.
birthday to you. Happy be a birthday to you. Happy be a birthday. Happy be a birthday. Happy be a birthday to you.
Thank God that you have turned around and come to Christ in Jesus' name. And we pray for all those who have been weak and got up and continue to walk and acknowledge God for who he is. I'm going to read this right here from 1 Corinthians 10 to 10. Yeah, from 10 to 12, or you can go all the way down. Let's read that here based on our conversation this morning for those who feel that God has, you know, not done anything for them, or God is not on their side and all this. Let's read this here, 1 Corinthians 10. It said, neither murmur ye, as some of them also murmured, and were destroyed of the destroyer. Now all these things happened unto them for ensamples, and they are written for our admonition, upon whom the ends of the world are come. Wherefore, let him that thinketh he standeth take heed lest he fall. There had no temptation taken you but such as is common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able, but will with the temptation also make a way to escape, that ye may be able to bear it. Amen. Let me read chapter 14. Wherefore, my dearly beloved, flee from idolatry. Amen. Well, hallelujah. Everything is in the book, man. Everything in the Bible. And if we look at the amount of people that have passed on before us and is written about in this book, based on, you know, all that they saw, the children of Israel coming out and saw God do all these things, open the Red Sea and all that, and they still was in had a problem to deal with it and to acknowledge God and stay in God's ways, you know what I mean? And imagine people now who look at the world and see that it was created by somebody. Everything that was created by somebody. Somebody did it. Somebody came up with the idea, you know what I mean? So if you acknowledge that, then, you know, hey, you got to reference God. You have to reference the person who created this. That's basically the kind of, you know, things that I want to say right now. You know, God is not, you know, gonna, you know, humble to you. Who are you? Who am I? We just people like who've been here, millions of people who've been here before. We must look at this in that kind of way, in that kind of humbleness, based on who he is and who we are. You know, and that is the perspective. You know, God don't owe you nothing. God don't owe nobody nothing. He gave us an opportunity that we can receive life or receive death. You know, he gave us a free will that we can choose the life that we want to live. And this is why from time to time, you know, I say this and I say that, you know, God is awesome, because when Choice Radio decided to definitely just go with the gospel 100%, I sat here and I was thinking like, well, you know, our logo before, our slogan before was one station, all people. The longer you listen, the better we sound. We used to say that all the time when we used to play all the jam and wine and all this stuff. And, you know, that was our motto before. You know, the longer you listen, the better we sound. You know, one station, all people, because we play all genres from all countries, whatever it is. We were, you know, kind of that kind of way. And the Holy Spirit just said to me in my spirit, your life, your salvation, your choice. Just like that, in the spirit. I just heard it. It was clear and it was perfect. And it is perfect. You know what I mean? So God is there working on our behalf who are willing to walk with him. You know, so any man had to come to God in a humble spirit. You must come in that kind of way. And this is something that any man who have any sense in his head to think of it like this. The amount of people that die in this world already and you know, whatever it is, you must be thankful that you are here. You have life and you're existing and God has given you a chance. So, you know, it's kind of a way to say it, but if you sit there and feel, well, oh, you know, you're not the worst, you know, you're not the worst, and, you know, you're not the first person that been through some difficulty or had some bad things happen in your life, and I know sometimes according to how some things come across, it somebody might say, well, W7, you could talk on the radio, you could say what you want, but you wasn't there, you didn't go through it, you don't know what it felt like. Well, you know, hey, that might be true, that might be so, but what's the bigger picture? Once you got life, you got hope, you know what I mean? And God wants you to believe that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him, you know what I mean? And he expects us to use that. He's given us that, and he wants us to use that and come to him knowing that he is who he is. That's why if a person don't reverence God in a reverence kind of fashion, it is not easy for you to get God to come to your level. There must be some sort of reverence for who he is, you know what I mean? And that's very important for anybody to understand. And you know, you as a believer, if you believe in God and you have a heart for God, I always say that, you know, like, if you have a heart for God, don't let nobody destroy that heart that you have for God. Because there are times somebody might feel, well, oh, you're so soft and you're so calm and you're so giving or you're so loving. Man, that's the heart of God. You know what I mean? That's the heart of God. And people could feel they could advantage you and they go, well, they're just wasting their time with that. because nobody could ill-treat the children of God, or to make the children of God be ashamed of being good and being righteous and being holy. Nobody can do that. So you just keep that going if you have that, and you have that reverence of who God is. James 1 and 13, it said, well, I'm going to go from 12. James 1 and 12. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord had promised to them that love him. Let no man say when he is tempted, I am tempted of God, for God cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempteth he any man. But every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. Then when lust hath conceived, it bringeth forth sin, and sin, when it is finished, bringeth forth death. Do not err, my beloved brethren. Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, and cometh down from the Father of lights, which with whom is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. Of his own will begat he us with the word of truth, that we should be a kind of first fruit of his creatures. Amen. So it's something that we as believers have to strive for. We have to strive for it. We have to do it, because God has given us the power within us to say yes or to say no for something, regardless to how it feel like, regardless to how persuasive it feel, or how friends might be telling you, or whatever. You have to determine in your heart what you want to seek. And once you seek the things of God, God is going to then empower you, because God has given us a free will. He's not going to force you to be righteous and force you to be holy and force you to serve him. No, you have to try to do it with the willingness of what he has given you, which is strength. He has given you education. He has given you brain. He has given you all the different things that you can say, well, okay, I'm taking a stand for this, or I'm taking a stand for that. And when you take a stand for God's side, then God is going to empower you through his Holy Spirit and help you to continue your walk with him. So it's very important for us to be very definitive in our move for God, that we are making a stand. Once you are making a stand for God and your intention is right, God is not going to fail you. God will never let you down. If your intention and your motives are right, God will never let you down. God will never cause you to be a shameful sight in the eyes of your enemies or your foes, or whatever it is. God is never gonna, once you continue to hold up his principles. One other thing that happens in life, sometimes we start going with God, but if God is not operating in the way we think he should operate, in a sort of freshly perspective, we tend to leave God and just get to our normal fleshly self, and then we spoil it, because now we get in. And once you go against the plan of God, then you give the devil room to operate. And many a time we don't realize that. We tell God to do it, but we're not going to stand still and see salvation, knowing that he works from the spirit and then manifests into the flesh. So we have to wait for God's full manifestation. If we believe in him, and we trust in him, we have to allow him to then do what he's going to do. We now need to stand still and see what he's going to put in place as we continue to wait on him and do his will. You know what I mean? That's why he said to seek me first, the kingdom of God, and all my righteousness, and everything will be added unto you. It means while you are seeking God, God is doing your work. You're working for me, and I'm working for you. And that is the concept. You know, but some of us, sometimes, from time to time, we all go through that state of infancy, or go back to that state of weakness where, we don't feel it's happening in the way it's supposed to happen, or it's not happening how we would have it happen from our fleshly perspective. But God is God, and God knows best, and all things work together for good for those who love the Lord. So we have to always come back to that place, that once we have put our trust in God, know that God will work it the best way possible. You know what I mean? Because you might have something that you see, well, da 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 da, but God is looking to dot every I and cross every T, that when it's finished, it's really finished for true. It's totally finished. Everything has been done. So once we can get to that place in Christ, we definitely have a great future with him. So as the time continued to move, 13 minutes on the other side of 9, and like I said, whatever we raise in the morning time in this segment while you're going to work or while you're getting yourself situated and stabilized on your job and you listen to us, it's just to, you know, raise some awareness or to raise something that would have us think a little bit as to how far we have come and to what are we dealing with and how can we perfect God in our life. How can we see Jesus, you know, in all the pages of the Bible come alive in our life? How can we really truly apply Jesus, that Jesus will be seen to be the truth and the life? You know what I mean? Amen. So we do thank everybody who participated, everybody who called and shared something. That is really what the Christian family should be about, edifying the body of Christ. And you know, if you look at God and God creating the heaven and earth, and look at all the different mechanics that God has put together with the sun coming up and the moon and all these different things, you know, God is a wise God and God is a serious God. To do this kind of thing and keep at it for all this, how much years, God is a serious God. And it's important that we take God serious and his children, you know, apply that kind of seriousness in life, that kind of diligence, you know what I mean? There's no time for all this idle chatter and idle talk and idle conversation, words that have no meaning in it, because those words that you speak just from just talking, they will manifest life, because the words is life. You know what I mean? So as a believer, we have to make sure we don't say things just to say it, because it's a slang and everybody say it, oh, you wish you were dead, and oh, you know, he could kill you now and all this kind of stuff. You know, we don't talk this kind of stuff. We have to stay away from it. I know many things that we have, you know, from as we are growing up, we got so used to certain terminologies that we use and certain things we say, certain joke that we think is joke we make. We have to be very diligent in cutting off some of those things that have no, you know what I mean, good result for us as believers in the body of Christ. Amen. So just want to share this. Let me do that song for my sister, requested this song from Shekinah Glory, song called Jesus. Let's take a first listen. First time I'm hearing it too.
Jesus,
sweet
precious name
Jesus.
Of Jesus.
Jesus.
The powerful name
Jesus.
Of Jesus.
Jesus.
How he loved me.
Jesus.
I will never know.
Jesus.
How he cared for me.
Jesus.
The precious name of and all he's done for me.
Jesus.
I can't help but give him glory.
Jesus.
He is God all by himself.
Jesus.
Come on, give him glory.
Jesus.
At the name of Jesus, demons must flee.
Jesus.
That's the kind of power he's given us. To that sickness and it will leave.
Jesus.
That's what he said in his word, yeah.
Jesus.
He said, I've come to give you life more abundantly.
Jesus.
That's what he did at the cross for you and me.
Jesus.
That's what he did at the cross for you and me.
Jesus.
That's what he did at the cross for you and me. But I'm so glad he rose on the third day.
Jesus.
With all power in his hand.
Jesus.
Yeah.
And to Brother Brian, your wife to be said, you're definitely a winner. Amen.
Jesus.
Keep that in the atmosphere. Keep that in the air. Morning to my beautiful wife.
Jesus.
Thank God for you.
Precious.
Amen.
Glorious.
And to all the husbands, give thanks for your wives right now.
The name of Jesus.
As you keep looking for that gem in them.
No other name I know. I'm talking.
Hey, Sister Veronica. What's going on?
Oh, he loved me.
Sister Verna, the Waltz family, Sister Hazelton, Sister Odette Morning, Sister Rosalyn,
handle it, daughter.
Lots of listeners, man. Thank you in the name of Jesus, all right?
I'm born on the cross for you. Nobody.
Don't forget to write us at P.O. Box 316, Brooklyn, New York 11203. P.O. Box 316, Brooklyn, New York 11203. P.O. Box 316, Brooklyn, New York 11203. Choice Gospel Network, Choice Gospel Ministry.
His name.
As we bless His holy name.
His name.
Yes.
Jesus.
Hope you were blessed this morning with the segment.
No.
Like I said, whatever we do is just to lift up the name of Jesus in every application. But we're going to know that He is.
Jesus.
He was and is and is to come. Yes.
Jesus.
Brother Stephen, morning, man. The Foster. Morning, Jesus.
Help me worship
Jesus.
You know what? The music don't even have to play.
Jesus.
For me to give Him worship.
Jesus.
The music don't even have to play.
Jesus.
For me to give Him worship.
Jesus.
You know what she said?
Of course, there are days you're not going to feel all that. But you have to strive to maintain your posture, you know what I mean? The enemy going to come at you and make you forget if you know Jesus. What a liar. Maintain your walk.
I got to give Him glory.
You know where you came from. I know where I came from.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Let Him set you free all the way. All those on the jobs, good morning.
Jesus.
Jesus.
And like I said, those of you, if you don't have a job, a 9-to-5, you still have a job with Jesus. I encourage you to get on the train, get on the bus.
Come on, give Him.
Go to the mall somewhere and sit beside somebody and tell them there is a name that is above every name, which is Jesus.
Come on.
That is our duty right now. That's why we're all a denomination. It's all about Jesus, man.
Glory, hallelujah.
That should be our interest.
Glory.
Getting people saved to know Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The name that saves.
Oh, yeah.
Not bringing people into our church or organization.
Jesus.
Getting them to Jesus.
Yeah.
Stop taking them for yourself.
Jesus.
On that day, many will say, Lord, Lord. Say, who are you?
Yeah.
Make sure you don't fall in that category. Allow nothing to stop you and cause you to stumble on Jesus. Bring them to Jesus. Amen.
Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. Choice Radio.
White family.
Uh-huh. Your name.
Hey, Neville.
When my troubles surround me and I didn't have to despair, Lord, you told me that you'd be right there. It seemed like all my problems had just begun, but I didn't have to worry no more. They were all. When I needed you, Jesus, all I had to do was call. Sometimes it was in the morning, sometimes late at night. But when I get up on my knees, Jesus.
We got a few more minutes inside this segment. If you're out there and you want to encourage somebody this morning who felt that Jesus let him down, feel free to call on that behalf. You know, somebody's listening. Maybe I'm not able to persuade them, but maybe you will. Give us a call if you want to encourage somebody to keep holding on to God's unchanging hand this morning. 347-663-8638. Wherever you are this morning, if you know he's a rock, you want to encourage somebody, take one or two calls. If you're out there this morning and you want to encourage somebody to keep holding on to God's unchanging hand. If you want, to encourage somebody this morning to hold on to his unchanging hands. It's a Maggie morning.
Hey, Caleb, Peyton. I have traveled a lonely road. Some things I just never understood. I have tried sometimes. I've made some mistakes. I've been searching for
Let's go to the phone caller. Good morning.
Hi, Double O. Good morning. How are you?
I'm great. How are you doing?
I'm Pamela Claiborne. I didn't go to church last night because it was snowing. I call you for prayer for my left side. The both side is hurting, and they don't want to move. The legs doesn't want to move. I have to keep pulling the left side on. Friday, it seized up on me, and it wouldn't go. But I still believe in God that He can heal.
Amen.
So I was asking for prayer.
I was just about to ask you that. So we're gonna believe together, and let me tell you, Amen. after we finish praying, we just gonna operate as if this thing has been already done. Amen.
Done. Amen.
Father,
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, we thank you that Praise you God. Are the great I am. You are the great physician. No one can come close to you. You have made us,
Amen,
Almighty
Amen.
God. So, Father, as we come to you this morning, knowing of your history and knowing what you have already done, God, we know that there is no limit to what you can do. Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus, you have given us that privilege that we can come to you, God. If anything is wrong, Father, we bring this sister this morning to you, Almighty God, with the pains that the enemy is trying to restrict on her body and put into her system to cause her not to function, Almighty God. Father, in the Amen. Name of your Jesus, with the name of your Son Jesus, with the blood that He has shed, Almighty God, we claim Praise victory God. In the name of Jesus. Father, we claim healing and deliverance and restoration right now in the name of Jesus. And we know that it's done because you are God Amen. That does not lie and cannot lie. So, Father, we receive Amen. It and we thank you for it in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Be blessed,
amen.
My sister.
Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Double O. You know, I didn't come last night because it's hard for me to go in the snow, pulling my legs. No.
God understand, Almighty God. He
yes,
understand
yes.
everything. So once you're sincere with God, He is
yes, I am.
A great I am. God, and He knows all. All right, my sister?
Okay. Thank you so much.
You're
Have
welcome.
A great day.
Say thanks to God. Amen.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Amen. So my sister, just receive it, believe it, operate in it.
I've been running for a long time.
Anybody want to encourage somebody this morning? Miss Pamela, thank you for calling. And thank you for receiving Christ as your Lord and Savior. And this is a kind of a classic case of somebody who might be going to church for a long time and you're thinking that you're saved, but you're not. And it's important that we understand that you must receive God, Jesus Christ, as your Lord and Savior. You must testify with your mouth. And then you denounce the devil. That is one of the way that you start off the process. And he said, those who believe and is baptized will be saved. And then you have to move to the next step, which is to baptize. You understand me? Drop the old man and rise new in Christ. So those things must be established to really, solidify your going into Christ. So that's important for somebody out there. So I heard about stories where somebody went someplace and they take a little cup with a little water and they pour it on top of your head. So guys, there's a lot that we got a lot of work to do, man. We got a lot of work to do. And do believers in the body of Christ who out there, we need you to operate in your capacity. And tell a friend, tell somebody that they need to seek the Lord and seek the truth of his word.
I've been running for a long
time. Amen.
Hiding wherever I could.
You need to know for yourself.
I have traveled
what God has recommended.
Oh.
Amen.
Some things I just.
And you might be listening today just because God wants you to hear.
I've tried
what you're supposed to hear. So that you're gonna make the right actions in your life. That you can prove him.
I've been searching.
Miss S, good morning again. Keep that smile on your face.
Found it in one place.
Coming from so far, my sister. If you've been walking with the Lord for a long time and days you don't really feel all that, and keep going on, the flesh is always going to try to go against you.
My heart has been broken too, hurt by the people I knew. I have struggled to realize the gifts that were hidden. And I have cried sometimes. I've made some mistakes. I've been searching for answers and only found it in one place. Been running for a long time, hiding in places you could. If you have traveled a lonely road, some things you just never understood. You will cry sometimes, you might make some.
Still need somebody to send out an encouragement to somebody out there, if you're there. Don't be shy, don't be intimidated. Call and encourage somebody to keep going on with Jesus. You've been around for a while. You have not slowed your riding. Amen. From time to time, we all need this kind of encouragement. Amen. We are body, so we all need each other.
'Cause all I ever wanted, all I really needed was him.
Things.
I can mount on wings like
9:42.
So when I call on Jesus,
listen, good morning to you. It is Arise
I'm gonna
in the morning time with yours truly 007.
Of heaven and earth too.
Never be afraid. Trust an unknown future to a known God. So we keep calling on Him.
I can mount on wings.
Remember all self-effort.
So
is but sinking sand. Christ the solid rock of salvation. Amen. Renny Greenwich. What's up, my brother? You alright? Live as though Christ died yesterday, rose from the grave today, and is coming back tomorrow. Come on. Lowen Henry. All the fans. Amen. All the family praying for church reading. Yeah. Oh, indeed. And my sister, the song really blessed me. The one Jesus from the Shekinah glory. Amen. 9:44. If you're on the job already, situated. Hope we have been a blessing to you. Sister Veronica Money. When you call him, he's gonna answer. That's why in times like this, even if you call and somebody don't call to encourage you, you gotta be able to encourage yourself. Amen. Stand on your own 2 feet. Be encouraged yourself. Amen. 9:45. All those driving, be cautious on the roads. Black eyes. Pamela, just meditate on 1 Peter 2:24, Isaiah 53:4-5, Matthew 8:17. First Peter 2:24, Isaiah 53:4-5, Matthew 8:17.
If you're tired and scared of the madness around you, if you can't find the strength to carry on, or when you call on Jesus, all things are possible. You can mount on wings like eagles and soar. When you call on Jesus, mountains are gonna fall, 'cause He'll move heaven and earth to come
morning, right? As we started, thank you for taking the time out to listen to the segment as presented by the Holy Spirit. As we lift up the name that is above every name, which is Jesus. Amen. If it's not Jesus, nothing is happening. It's gotta be Jesus. Only name that can save, as we once again go back to James 1, and I'm going to start it from James 1 and 12. That we're going to just dwell on that scripture for the day. Let that go with you all day in Radio Land. Those of you who have given up on God and thought that God has not come true and whatever it is, but we're going to just live that with you, that you will meditate and know that God is in your best interest. Amen. James 1, 12. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation. For when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. Let no man say when he is tempted, I am tempted of God. For God cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempteth he any man. But every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. Then when lust hath conceived, it bringeth forth sin, and sin, when it is finished, bringeth forth death. Do not err, my beloved brethren. Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, and cometh down from the Father of lights, with whom is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. Of his own will begat he us with the word of truth, that we should be a kind of first fruit of his creatures. Amen. So let's give God praises. Let's give him honor. Let's give him glory. And if we look at that scripture, we are all guilty from time to time. Don't care how close we have walked with the Lord, that sometimes we go to God last instead of coming first. We all can say amen to that. So let us be responsible in our actions and attitudes towards the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, the Creator of heaven and earth. The El Shaddai, you understand me? The all-knowing God, the God of more than enough, the God of everything, the God of the beginning and the end. Let's give him credit according to who he is and what he has already proven to us in his holy word, that he is a God that cannot change. The scriptures say there is no variableness in him. You know, he's stabilized. He doesn't change what he's doing. He keep his promise. So we know that we have variableness in us. Let us acknowledge God that way. If you are there this morning and you have listened to this segment and there was some heaviness in your heart or some hardness, some resentment towards God because of something that happened, let's go back. Let's turn the pages back. Let's go back. Let's look at people who have been through worse than you, and they have come through. They have pulled through. They have made some choices in their life that was different from yours and came with an outcome, different outcome. Let's also look back at, you know, the same 24 hours in a day that is given to you is given to me and every other man that ever existed on the face of the earth. Let's look back. There are many things we can look back in life and know that we are the one that has been responsible for what has happened in our life. And let's take it from there. Once we have life, we have hope. And God is willing to answer you today. Whatever is your situation, whatever is your predicament, God, the great Almighty God, Jesus, has given us that line, that connection with him, that we can go through Jesus and connect to him. So we are thankful and we are grateful today that we have been given that opportunity. Let us use it as we acknowledge our faults and shortcomings before the great I am that I am indeed. Let's not take it personal. You know, once you got life, you got hope. There is no reason why you should live this life without knowing Jesus. And everybody know that we must die. There is a day that is appointed. Some people is appointed today. Probably that's the last time you ever hear radio. The time the radio to whatever we leave the program, that's it. You know, you would not be here tomorrow and hear what we're going to be coming with, you know, if God allow us to be back. So I'm saying to you, don't allow anything in this life to take you away from the great promise of eternal life. You know what I mean? Because it doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense. I know every man is given their free will, but we just want to let you know there is much more to life than what meet the eyes right about now. And it's important that you pay attention to the gift that is given to you by the grace of God, that he's allowed you to you know, live for another day to hear a program of such caliber, you know what I mean? That you can make a different move in life, you can make a change today, and that's what life is about, making changes. When we find out what it is, we go ahead and make some adjustment and tweak it a little bit, you know what I mean? So we thank everyone for listening to the segment today, and like I said, we always come with the intention to uplift the name of Jesus, that his people will be enhanced, you know what I mean? And be encouraged to continue to walk for him. That is why he has saved us in such a time like this. We are grateful, we are thankful that we have been used as a vehicle, as something that, you know, something that can bring forth some life, or help to bring forth some life, amen? So we thank you once again, all those who have participated, all those who have contributed testimonies or call and give some sort of information. We know it was well received by those who should receive it, and we hope that everyone should receive it for what it is. You know what I mean? Amen? All right.
That the Lord of all the earth would care to know my name, would care to feel my hurt. Who am I that the bright and morning star would choose to light the way for my ever wandering heart? Not because of who I am, but because of what you've done. Not because of what I've done, but because of who you are. I am a flower quickly fading, here today and gone tomorrow. A wave tossed in the ocean, vapor in the wind. Still you hear me when I'm calling. Lord, you catch me when I'm falling, and you've told me who I am. I am yours. I am yours. Who am I that the eyes that see my sin would look on me me rise again? Who am I that the voice that calmed the sea would call out through the rain and calm the storm in me? Not because of who I am, but because of what you've done. Not because of what I've done, but because of who you are. I am a flower quickly fading, here today and gone tomorrow. A wave tossed in the ocean, a vapor in the wind. Still you hear me when I'm calling. Lord, you catch me when I'm falling.
Give him praise for who he is.
I am yours.
Thank him that you are chosen. Amen. Many have gone before. We are grateful, we are thankful. Father, we thank you for choosing us in our state. So James 1 and 12, from 12, that's the scripture for today.
But because
take it somebody and read it and go through it, you know, really see what it's saying.
You told me who I am.
morning to all pastors. Keep doing the work faithfully. Miss Morrison, good morning. Keep doing it faithfully, all pastors, all preachers. Keep doing it. It's too much to gain to lose. Amen. Don't let nothing stop you, man, from doing it honestly for your Father. You know what I mean? Don't let nothing stop you. Once again, happy birthday to you, my brother Brian, and we thank God that you have found Christ and Choice Radio was somewhat instrumental in starting that. Amen. We give God thanks for you today. We give him praise and honor and glory. As I said, even if one person that this mission on Choice Radio is for, to catch and capture all day and bring to God, we are willing to do it. As long as God is going to give us the opportunity to be able to do it, we give him praise and we give him honor and we give him glory, because we know he is worthy to be praised. Amen. So we continue to encourage you out there. Don't care what the world is throwing at you. It's much bigger picture than that. You know what I mean? Continue to hold on to God's unchanging hands. He's worthy. He's faithful. Amen. Don't care what it feels like. I know what you're talking about. I know. I understand. Don't care what it feels like. Just imagine the glory to come. All these people cannot be wrong. All these experiences, all these testimonies could never be wrong. Amen. As a matter of fact, we've been on the other side and we know what they have to offer. Lies and lies and more lies. Yeah. Amen. Thank God he's opened our eyes, that we know that we know that we are now walking in the truth. Amen. So as we continue to strive, always try to close with this, as we remind each other what God is expecting of us, that we can complete this mission flawless. Amen. In the spirit. Galatians 5:16. This I say then, walk in the spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusteth against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh, and these are contrary the one to the other, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. But if ye be led by the Spirit, ye are not under the law. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envyings, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and such like. Of thee which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do thus such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. And they that are Christ have crucified the flesh with the affections and lust. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Let us not be desirous of vain glory, provoking one another, envying one another. Amen. And we can achieve it once we walk in the Spirit. Amen. We allow the Spirit of God to flow by us being obedient to what he has requested us to do. We abstain from what is not godly. We strive to do what is right. Amen. As we strive to submit to God and allow his will to be done in our lives, resist the devil and he's going to flee. Amen. So guys, it's been my pleasure. I thank you for the calls. I thank you for all those who write to Choice Radio. We appreciate you guys. P.O. Box 316, Brooklyn, New York 11203. All those who have written to us, we definitely appreciate you, and we look forward to you who have not. Amen. But we thank God for all that he's doing and all that he has done. He continue to sustain us and keep us. And we give him praise because he's worthy to be praised. Father, in the name of your son Jesus, we come before you this morning knowing that all things flow through you. Without you, Almighty God, there was nothing that was made. And you made everything, Almighty God. So, Father, we are thankful that we are enjoying the abundance of your creation. Father, we give praise to no other name, that is the name that is above every name, which is Jesus. Because only through Jesus there is life. Amen. And we thank you, Father God. We glorify you. Let your name be praised. All praise and honor be unto you, Almighty God, as we reduce to nothing and allow you to be God in this segment. Father, we hope that we have done you justice, that men will be drawn to you today, Almighty God. Take all your glory, take all your praise. It all belongs to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Together for
fails. All right, stand by. We're gonna be, you know, just off for a minute doing something. We're gonna reset something. So keep it locked to Choice Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice. As we lift up the name of Jesus, be blessed. Have a great day in the name of Jesus. Amen. All right.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.